everyone, welcome back to another video. I, Srishti Mishra, legal attorney, LexClick & Company, is going to present today's new topic, that is battery, which comes under law of torts. Okay, so just moving ahead with the topic, it is very important for us to know that this video does not solicit any kind of promotion or advertisement under the guideline of Bar Council of India. Sole purpose of this video is only for educational purpose. Let's get started with the video. So talking about battery, that comes under law of torts. So every man, every person, every individual, you and me, have right to deserve their protection of his life and liberty, right of life and the personality, and the other obligations is to protect others' rights. So it's very important for us, it is very important for you and me to protect ourselves' right plus the others' rights too. So but sometimes what happens that sometimes these rights these rights is infringed, and sometimes it happens some wrong with the person, wrong with the individual, and because of that the here a term is used, that is we can save these wrongs which are hurting someone, which are hurting some individual. So this can be said as trespass to person. So there are following forms of trespass of person. So we'll be discussing about forms which are. So one of the form of trespass is battery. Okay, so we're going to discuss about now battery. So what is battery actually? So battery is an actual person, any person to whom anyone is touching in a rude manner, angry manner, revengeful manner. So these can be called as battery. It's not that one battery which is used in laptop, phones and etc. electronic devices. This is not that one. This is the battery which is used in law of tort. Okay. So any person, any individual to whom any other person is touching with a rude manner, angry manner, revengeful manner, that can be called as battery. So battery is the actual and intentionally applications of any physical force to an adverse nature to the person of another without his consent. Without his consent, if anyone is touching with the rude and revengeful manner, so it will be known. It will be known as the battery in law of torts. So section 350 of IPC use of criminal force mentioned their use of criminal force. So battery is nothing, okay, it's nothing but the touching someone's other person with the against his will, however if done slightly, do not have anything in mind or do not have any intention to cause that person the harm, that person, but still if anything happened against her will, touching like in a rude manner, so it will come under battery. So there are essential elements which constitutes the battery. So first element is that use of force. So talking about use of force, so everything is used by force. So even though the force used by a person is very simple and does not constitute to harm that person, cause any harm to that person, but still it's committed. The battery is committed because the it was against the will of the person. Okay, so physical hurt need not to be there. Any physical hurt, like किसी को चोट लग जाना, it's not important कि उसको खून निकल गया, then only that will come under the battery. No, still you have pushed that person in a rude manner against her will, it's constitute a battery. So now for instance use of stick, ठीक है, spitting on a man face or slapping, stabbing, throwing a bottle over a person. So these all constitute a battery and use of force is there. Now another point is that is without lawful justification. So it is important that use of force should be intentionally and without any lawful jurisdiction, lawful justification. And the following acts here, two acts which I have listed, following two acts which are not held to be battery. Okay, so first one is to feed the hunger striker forcefully to save his life. Here we are saving someone's life. If someone is not eating food, we are forcefully telling that person to eat that food because of saving his life. So this does not constitute any any offense or battery. Another point is that performance of an operation on an unconscious person by a doctor. And second one is policeman arresting a person by applying the force if that person is a criminal, if that person has committed some crime, and is if he is not following what policemen are saying. So it is obvious that policemen will apply force, and if that force is applied, so here what happens, that battery is not no offense of battery scores. So there are difference in battery in civil and battery in crime. So the difference between battery as crime and battery as civil tort is merely the type of intent required. How the intent, what are the intention? If you have intention of causing someone harm, if not, if by mistake it has been done, the crime has been done. So there is a difference in the intent required and a criminal battery. Criminal battery required the presence of mens rea or a criminal intent, criminal minded person. I want to cause harm to that person. So this is criminal battery, and the criminal intent to do wrong, and according to defendant, found guilty, okay, of the crime. And a battery is often sued by the defendant in a civil action for the same offense, okay. So this is the difference. We talked about battery in this video, and I hope you find this video useful. And if you find this video useful, go and smash the likes button, subscribe to the channel, and let me know your feedback in the comment box below down. Till then, take care, goodbye.